Thanks for joining us. Joining me, all thanks to Farm Credit Mid-America, as we take a look at their relationship with local communities. We visit with Rick Chrysler. He's the administrator of, what's the name of the organization?
Foundation Dinners.
I think I knew that, but I want to make sure I got through it. So we showed up here, and you welcomed us in. Tell us a little bit about, as a food pantry, where does this program fit in for Lancaster and Fairfield County?
There is a lot of need down here. Well, there must be. We've been here 30 years, served meals every day for those 30 years, lunch and dinner, never missed a meal one time. We serve not just the homeless, we serve low-income families. We have families that work at Anchor Hocking that come over and eat, just low-income families, but we'll feed about anybody.
Now, Farm Credit put together a challenge for county fairs, and through that challenge, they collected food. What would that food and what did it do for you?
Well, Connie over to Fair Board surprised us, actually, and brought in a bunch of food that needed items. We use about anything, and especially the buns and water, especially the water. Water's a biggie because the homeless will be out on the streets and need water. So the buns, the water, all the canned goods, we used every bit of it.
Really, our best ideas come from at the grassroots level. And in this case, and you'll be talking to lately, as Jenny Schulteis had right in our backyard, says, hey, we've got food banks in our counties, we've got county fairs, and we've got this brand that is very strong in the ag communities. What if we work together, bring some trailers out to these fairs, work with the youth board members, and voila, you know, 21,000 pounds of food that we can donate to the, you know, to the food banks in these counties. So it's a big need, more than we realized in our counties. And so that's really the gist of the program.
Yeah, so we had 8 county fairs that accepted the challenge. What we saw from there was they came together and collected over 21,000 pounds and donated to 18 food banks across those 8 counties. Some of the cool things that they did, I know Guernsey and Muskingum did a mullet contest. So they took pictures of kids with these crazy mullets, put those pictures inside the stock trailer, and you went in and voted with canned food. And they did really, really well with it. Other fairs did where they grabbed golf carts and went around at the end of the fair week and gathered food from the campers and had people donate that way. So
Farm Credit is a large organization with a lot of pieces and parts within our different teams. Rural First is just a brand within Farm Credit where we work more on the consumer side, but you have your loan officers within Rural First and then the ag teams, and then you have your closing specialists, the customer service specialists, account specialists, the appraisal team. And so this was a way that all of our teams within Farm Credit could come together and support our local communities for a project that's going to help everyone.
Joining me is Connie Smith, and Connie is a director on the Fairfield County Fair Board. They wrap up the fair season every year with the last fair. This year, though, they came in first place in the Farm Credit Mid-America Food Drive. Connie, first of all, did you put a plan together? Did the kids get excited? What was it like to do this? Because fair's busy enough anyway.
Well, I will tell you, Dale, we kind of scratched our heads and said, how are we going to do this? You know, there's so much going on at a very large fair as Fairfield County, and then we got our junior leaders involved, which they're more community oriented. They like those community service projects. And so I went to a meeting and we talked about it, and we talked with our 4-H educators about it. I learned a lot more than I thought I would ever learn in saying yes to this project. And it wasn't the organization, it was I learned from a group of kids who have been in and out of school because of COVID in the last 2 years. In a really rapidly growing county, there's need. And one of the students said to us, you know, I know what I have for breakfast every morning at home, but the student sitting next to me, sometimes there's nothing at home to eat, so we have to do this project. So when you hear high school students in 4-H and FFA saying those words to you, then you know you just pull up your bootstraps and you make it happen. That's all you do, you make it happen.
So you collected nearly 5,000 pounds of donations. How many different places shared in that benefit?
Well, we had 8 different pantries that we contacted, that we talked to about what they needed, what they wanted. Exactly 4,925 pounds. I like to say 2.5 tons. It sounds so much better, you know. So anyway, we really worked hard at the effort, but what we did is we challenged each 4-H club. Our fair board received a $500 check, a participation fee. We gave that back to the clubs. So the five clubs that gave the most in weight, they each got a $100 check. So that went back to that club. And I know several of them sponsored pizza parties for the end of the year. And it's really funny. We had a totem board, you know, all during the fair, and we had competition. We had a lot of competition among the clubs that really wanted to win the $500. Or they each got $100, yeah.
Yeah, first place did come with a check, and you've unofficially received a check. What will you do with the winnings, and will the kids have a say?
Yes. Well, we actually talked to the kids before. You know, we are woefully behind in technology at our county fairgrounds. And so one thing we wanted to do was upgrade the entry process, upgrade technology.
There you go. It's that simple, and you can get involved this year with your county fair. I've been visiting with Connie Smith. She's the director of the Fairfield County Fair, one of 16 directors who got involved this year. But if you're thinking about maybe you want to do something for your food pantry, Farm Credit Mid-America is ready to help you out. Just stop in their office and tell them we want to know what we've got to do to get involved for this year, and we want to be planning, so be sure to let them know. This segment is brought to you by Farm Credit Mid-America.